I know best is subjective, okay? Obviously, the Model Y is not the best Tesla for every single person on planet Earth, but in a subjective manner, I'm gonna be arguing in today's video why I think the Model Y is the best Tesla yet, and I want you guys to know that this was not my first conclusion when they originally unveiled it. At first, when they first rolled this thing out on stage in this very, very poorly lit room, I remember reacting to the livestream thinking, it pretty much looks like a Model 3, you know? It's kinda taller than an average Model 3, and I'm sure it has the optional, you know, 7-seater, and it's a hatchback. Okay, big whoop. But what I've realized is that this is the combination of all of the best parts of Tesla into one single vehicle. So, for a lot of people out there, it is going to be the best Tesla, mainly because of practicality. SUVs are an incredibly popular demographic, especially in the United States, not just because people don't want to drive minivans because they have a certain stench with them, but also because they're very functional. They have a lot of practical use cases with them, and the Model Y has the best energy efficiency per mile of any electric SUV, which means that you can, for not really much more than a Model 3, get almost the exact same range, which I think was a big surprise for a lot of people, given Model 3 range listed on the website is around 322 miles, the Model Y is listed around 315, but once you factor in all of the different, you know, variables when it comes to range of a vehicle, what the temperature is outside, the incline of the roads you're driving on, how you're driving, also battery degradation in years, the range is almost the same. I mean, they're within 7 miles listed on the website, which in my opinion means that you can basically go with a Model Y and expect the same range as a Model 3. Yeah, the Model 3 might come a little bit ahead, but for the most part, you don't have to take a huge compromise in range, which is a huge plus. And while the Model 3 was a giant monumental moment for Tesla because they were finally able to reach these lower price points, and that meant that more people who were never buying a Tesla before could finally buy one and start using it. And yes, people who drive the Model 3 are very happy with it, but it is a mid-size sedan, and that market is kind of limited in what they can actually store in their vehicles. As someone who's driven around a Model 3, and I know how much trunk and frunk space they have, the Model Y is definitely going to be a big winner when it comes to how much stuff you can actually take around with you. The frunk is going to be deeper on the Model Y. The hatchback, thankfully, is a powered liftgate. Huge annoyance that a lot of Model 3 owners had with their Tesla, and based on some early access pictures we've seen of the Model Y, it seems like it's gonna have quite a bit of storage in the back. So, with an average price point of being around $3,000 to $4,000 more than a Model 3, the Model Y is borrowing that Model 3 structure of being affordable and having a very minimalistic interior while still prioritizing, you know, those fast version 3 supercharging charge rates, full self-driving capability, and all that. But they've taken what they've learned from Model 3 production, applied it to the Model Y so that they can bring things out ahead of schedule, not behind schedule. So, in my opinion, it's essentially a way Tesla has figured out how to finally just make a car and just not have to have a huge production hell stage, you know, where they have a bunch of, oh, we don't know when these are going to be ready yet, and oh, production is really, really hard right now. It was way harder than we thought it was going to be. Now that Tesla's been mass producing vehicles, they know how to handle it. They knew with the Model Y not to change too much so that the parts that they used with the Model 3 can be carried over to the Model Y as well. That saves the end consumer on cost, and it results in there being a much more practical vehicle that everyone gets to buy and enjoy. So Model S and X, really fun, really cool cars to drive, and the free unlimited supercharging is amazing as well, but there's a whole suite of design flaws with those Falcon doors, and the price point of them is much higher than what most people are willing to do. So the Model Y is able to bring that functional standpoint of having a hatchback, a powered liftgate, lots more cargo space in the back seats, and also a lot deeper frunk space, those benefits that the Model S and X have, and bring that into a more affordable market so that, yeah, you can now buy a Tesla that is still within reasonable prices while not having to compromise that much on the rest of the vehicle as a whole. That's why I think a lot of people are excited for it, even though at first glance it may just seem like a slightly bigger Model 3. That's exactly what the market is probably demanding right now, a version of the Model 3 that just improves on every aspect of the design. The only thing it's not better at is range and reaching those lower price points, but I, for one, am very curious to see what happens with the standard range, or if they're gonna call it standard range plus on the Model Y, because if it's anywhere near the standard range plus price point of the Model 3, then I'm sure Tesla was correct in assuming that the Model Y is going to outsell the 3, given it's much more applicable to the markets it's serving. So I'm glad to see that Tesla is able to make lightning strike twice in the same place. They aren't just a one-hit wonder with the Model 3, and clearly there's a lot of people excited to get theirs, so I can't wait to actually start seeing them on city streets. What do you guys think of the Model
why.
I'm sure a lot of you are just thinking, well, it may be the best Tesla yet until the Cybertruck, which I may agree with you, but let me know what you're thinking down below. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you have an excellent day. Take care.